Happy holidays, everybody. Eric Schneider here for GayLoveMatters.com, and I prepared this little survival guide for the holidays, considering how fast and furious they seem to be coming. I'm already late with this video, so stay tuned, and we'll talk more about how to survive and thrive during the holiday season. The holidays are a challenging time for everyone. Expectations are really, really high. History kind of presses up against us and can make this time of year very bittersweet. The expectations of the holiday season, thank you Norman Rockwell, and the Madison Avenue Christmas are very often very difficult to compete with. So, for couples, it can be hard. For families, it can be very hard. For single people, it can be very hard. And for newly single people, it can be very, very hard. So given all of that, I wanted to talk a little bit about, if you're alone on the holidays. Being alone and lonely on the holidays seems to be exacerbated by, again, the sort of expectations of what Christmas stands for. My premise here, essentially, is that the more prepared you are for the holidays, the better. And what that means is to kind of have a sense of what you're going to do during each holiday will be very helpful in the long-term experience of how you experience the holidays. So for me, I have personal traditions that I've carried out throughout my entire life, and I'll be adding some new traditions this year, and I will be thinking about what other traditions I might want to incorporate during this holiday time. So the first thing I'm going to do is on Christmas Eve, I will probably, even though I'm not Catholic or Christian, I will probably find a midnight mass to go to. I find that experience very powerful and very comforting, and also very inspiring. Then for Christmas Day, my personal tradition over the years has been to watch Christmas movies. I find them inspirational. I find them very nostalgic. They fill my heart with a sense of warmth and a sense of the season, and often are very reminding of what the season is about. So that would include some new ones. I do like the Santa Claus a lot, and the Santa Claus 1, Santa Claus 2, Santa Claus 3. And I also enjoy the old black and white ones, It's a Wonderful Life, and The Bishop's Wife, The Man Who Came to Dinner. If you haven't seen The Man Who Came to Dinner, as a black and white film with Bette Davis, I highly recommend it. I also really, really enjoy each and every year watching the old Alastair Sims' A Christmas Carol. His transformation is an extremely powerful and poignant moment in that movie. So that's what I'll be doing on Christmas Day. I usually traditionally take the week off from Christmas to New Year's, and what I do during that time is really take some time to plan out the year ahead and to sit with a notion of my kind of vision for myself and for my work and for my life, and work out some of the goals, the milestones of that for the year, and begin to map out what some of those tasks are. So that's how I spend that time. It's a reflective time for me. It's a time for self-nurturance, and it's a time for self-reflection, and it's a time for kind of planning ahead a little bit. Now, New Year's Eve traditionally looked a very particular way. It's not going to look that way this year. So I'm a practitioner of Aikido. I've been a practitioner of Aikido ever since I can remember, practically. And Aikido is a Japanese martial art. And every year at midnight, I think 11:30 to 12:30, there's a midnight practice at the New York Aikikai that I may avail myself of. If I don't do that, I'll spend some time sitting in front of the shrine in my office / apartment, and we'll spend a little quality time doing some meditation and reflection. And then New Year's Day will consist of some kind of New Year's brunch, probably a workout in the morning. Even when the holidays come, I don't drop my workouts, I don't drop my diet. I stay pretty consistent with that. And then it'll involve some holiday brunch. And that will be my holiday season in a nutshell. So my hope here is for you that the big takeaway, whether you're alone or with someone and the loneliness is emergent, being alone is not really a problem. It's not really about fulfilling some kind of expectation that you have, that you've been sort of fed over the years. It's actually about creating, in a sense, taking agency and taking charge of the holiday season and making the holidays something that you really, really want them to be, and knowing that you have the power to do that. The other piece I want to suggest here that I want you to take away is also keep your heart open. The reason I want you to keep your heart open is that that will allow you to be open to possibilities that might emerge and surprise you as the holidays unfold. So plan ahead and keep your heart open. Again, happy holidays. This is Eric Schneider for GayLoveMatters.com. And please, please subscribe to this channel. And if you have any comments or questions, please don't hesitate to let me know. I'll see you next time. Thank you.